One of the things we were talking about working in the studio, talking about being on stage. Obviously, you know, music is an inherently collaborative art form. What makes you a good collaborator?
What makes one, or what makes me myself? Well, I think my benefit as a collaborator is that I'm really well organized. Mm. So you're not going to lose a lot of ideas. I can kind of keep track of what we've done to that point. Mm-hmm. And I am always interested in hearing it the other way. I'm fine with that. But I don't placate. So if I don't think it's happening, or I think we as a group can do better, I'll suggest that we keep on digging. And I'm also totally fine abandoning things. Like, I will leave that idea, I'll leave this whole song on the cutting room floor and start a brand new one, no problem. Because I think that sometimes, like, good kids are born to bad parents, so to speak, in music. Like, this is a great melody, but we just put crappy chords on it and ruined it. But that doesn't mean that it doesn't serve a purpose. Like, it might be the bridge to this other song. So, like, instead of continuing to tussle with this, let's go over here and make something, like, create something fresh where we're not all tied up about it. Yeah. So I think I have a good ability to rudder the ship a bit.
Mm-hmm. And in your mind, speaking about, you know, what makes a good collaborator, not you, but what do you look for in a collaborator?
For me, because I have that ability to kind of move around and pretty fluid, I like people that are like straight arrows. I don't know, click well.
You want to be kind
of I want you to believe in what you put out there and not be sensitive if it's not the thing that flies. But collaborating really is like alchemy. You have to know what you bring to the table and what kind of person you want to be around. And some of my favorite collaborators are really mean people.
Yeah. But you know where they stand.
But I know where they stand. It's like, yep. Cool. Yeah.